You may fall off your chair now because my Maybelline Superstay finally got dethroned. Whole update video, wow. Okay, this is going to be a long ass video probably. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. I'm looking a little bit down because otherwise you are blinded by my glasses. Because yes, this is a glasses day. Today, my favorites and fails video. In this video, I am going to talk about the products that, well, either were my absolute favorites this month, so that I kept grabbing, or were just a total dud. Basically, the okays I'm going to leave for my whole update video that is coming as well, and you will see that this look in that video too, just so you know, a little heads up. But you know what, let's just go into the video. I will list the products that I talk about down below. If I did a video on them, I will mention it and I will link it down below as well. Yes, okay, let's just start, and let's start with my fail. So my fail for this month, and I'm really, really bummed about that, is the Kiko Milano foundation. Technically, this is from my birthday haul, or this is from my birthday haul, so maybe it shouldn't be in this video, but I'm going to mention it anyway. I tried this any which way I can possibly think of. If I first apply it, it looks really, really pretty. The trouble is it doesn't want to stick to my skin. I tried it with different sunscreens underneath. Or without a sunscreen. Not that I'm a fan of that, but I thought let's try it anyway. I tried it without primer. I tried it with primer. I tried it with my favorite primer that you will see in just a minute. I even got a brand new primer to try underneath this one, which is a water-based primer without silicones, because I thought maybe that's it. You know, that it kind of doesn't want to play with the silicones. It just doesn't matter. It doesn't want to stick to my skin. Especially on my upper cheek area. So when I just applied, it looks really, really nice. It looks like skin. It's really pretty. It's a light coverage. But again, it's really pretty. Then, however, everything I put on top of that, it just breaks down the foundation. So I thought, okay, you know what? Maybe I should just, you know, use it as a BB cream and not put anything on top. If I don't powder it, it keeps sliding around, so I need to powder it. Otherwise, when I just touch my skin lightly, I have a finger mark on my skin in the foundation. So I need to powder it. I tried it with all the powders that I have. The powder I use with Trouble Foundations is the Maybelline Fit Me. It didn't matter. It looked cakey. It started breaking up the foundation. It's just really, really annoying, and I'm so freaking bummed about that. So yeah, if you have this foundation and you got it to work for you, please let me know down below how you did it. Because it's the Skin Tone foundation. I have Neutral 10. I'm going to use it up, but just for filming only. That's basically the way I'm going to use it, just like with my stick foundation from Revolution. I am going to mention that, however, in just a second. Let's go to the favorites now then, and shall we? And let's start with this one. And this one is from Catrice. It's from their Liquid Camouflage line. It's new, and it is their under eye primer, and this stuff is amazing. I hate the word holy grail, but this is it. This is so freaking amazing. Let me tell you a little bit about this. If you have watched some of my videos, especially some tutorials, you may have seen me apply it. I tap this in. It's a doe foot. You apply it, then you tap it in. You let it sit for a little while. Any concealer I put on top, I can make work. Remember this one? The Conceal and Define that I tried any which way I knew how, and then just use the contour or to set my eye, or as eyeshadow primer, I can make it work underneath my eye. When I use this underneath that concealer, it does not dry out my under eyes anymore. So yeah. I freaking love this stuff. That's basically, yeah. What else? I have a lot of trouble with concealer creasing, especially here. I can just remove my glasses. Especially here, close to my eye. If I use this and I tap it out really well, let it sit, it still creases, but it creases a lot less. Does that make any sense? So yeah, I freaking love this stuff. If you see this in store, grab it and try it because it's freaking amazing. I hope this is in their permanent collection. The next product is also from Catrice. It is the 1 minute face perfector, and this stuff though, it's just, you put this on your skin and when you're buffing it in, because I use it with a brush. I can also do it with my fingers, but I like applying it with a brush. And the brush I will mention a little bit later. Oh no, I can mention it now though. This is the brush I use to buff it in. This is technically a highlighter brush. Does not really matter, but I use this to buff it in. You can see your skin transforming. So you put it on your skin. You can see that it has a little bit of a tint, but then you go and buff it in. It blurs. It smooths. It does not collect into lines. It evens out my skin tone. And when you feel it, it does not feel sticky. It doesn't feel silicony. It just feels smooth and soft. You know, the way your legs feel after you've just shaved them and the cream you put on top has really set in. That soft smoothness, that's the way your face feels then. So yeah. I tried this under a lot of foundations. I can even make the stick foundation from Revolution work a bit better. I cannot make it work entirely because it keeps breaking up here no matter what I do. But this though makes it break up less. Does that make any sense? I can put it on top of a primer as well. So if I need a hydrating primer, I put that on first. Then I can put this on top, no problems. It's not pilling, it's not sliding around. It just really, it's so freaking good. When I put this underneath, for instance, the Estée Lauder Double Wear, which is a little bit drying for my skin, but I freaking love. It doesn't dry out my skin anymore. So if you have dry skin, if you have texture, pores, maybe some lines, if you have an uneven skin tone, try it. It is amazing. A lot of the time I use this on my face and maybe a little bit of concealer and that's it. It's so freaking good. And I've put quite a dent in it. So yeah, this is from their new line as well. If you see it in store, grab it because it is freaking amazing. Okay, this is going to be a long-ass video, probably. So I'll try to speed things up, shall we? So I have those. I have a new favorite foundation. So yeah, if you have watched my latest Foundation Friday, it will not be a surprise. If you have missed that video, you may fall off your chair now because my Maybelline Superstay finally got dethroned. I found a new favorite foundation. It's this one from Primark. This is the PS My Perfect Color Double Coverage Matte Foundation. I have mine in the color, what is it, beige, which is technically a tiny bit too dark for me at the moment. This is so good. I did a review on it. I will link it down below because I need to speed it up. This is, I said it in that video as well, this is a new favorite. Go check out the review and you know what I mean, basically. Next is the One Drop Concealer from Catrice. I use this in a first impression as well. It's just a tiny bottle. It comes with a dropper. It's really, really thin and runny, but it packs so much coverage. It's insane. It's really lightweight. Yes, it creases. It does, especially here, close to my eye, it creases, it creases, but when I put this one underneath, it creases less. But just because this is so light and watery, it can crease, but it is fantastic. I have mine in the color, I don't know, light beige, I think. So yeah, fantastic. I will link the first impression that I did with this concealer down below. The Catrice powders. Yes, let's go to the Catrice powders next. I have two, and my favorite way to use them actually is to kind of combine them. I can use this one, which is, I'm sorry for the shine, the Glow Illusion Loose Powder from Catrice. It looks like this, and it is a thicker, more fatty powder, if that makes any sense. For my dry skin, this powder is just amazing because it doesn't dry it out. I can even use it to set my under eye area, although now that the weather is kind of changing and getting a little bit warmer again, I actually like to use this one, the All Matte Pressed Powder. The All Matte Pressed Powder. In my T-zone and underneath my eyes. And then if I need it on the rest of my face, I will use this one, or I will use it to buff. It's amazing. If you have dry skin but you still want or need a powder, try the Glow Illusion Loose Powder from Catrice. It's really, really nice. If you like to buff, try that one out as well. Okay, so that was the powders. Go away. Yes. I don't really have a favorite bronzer. I just grab what I want. I do, however, have a favorite blush. And it is an older one. It's the Flower Beauty Sweet Pea. I freaking love this blush. I love the color. I don't have it on today because I tried a new blush today. I love this blush. I think the color is so freaking pretty. It's so pretty. It's a cool tone blush. You cannot see it. It's a cool tone blush, but it's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. Okay. Next, I have listed everything down here. So let's go to brushes. Yes, let's do that. So I have a bunch of brushes here. Let's start with this one, which I just showed you. This is from LOV. It is technically their highlighter brush, but this is the brush I use for my primer that you just saw. And I actually like this one for foundation as well. But I love it for my primer. And it's like a buffing brush or whatever. It's a brush like this. It's a bit rounder. It's a little bit looser. I don't know. I just love this one for my primer. Okay. Next one is this. This is a freaking amazing brush. The trouble is though, this is from AliExpress and I don't think that they sell it anymore. I've seen, does MAC have one of these? I think they do. This is just, you see the shape. It's really fluffy. And this is the brush I use. Sometimes I even use it for blush. I use it for bronzer. I just use it to buff. I freaking love this brush. And I hope that they will restock it because I need more. I love, love, love this brush. Next brushes I have are from Morphe. Let's do these two separately. Let's go to these three first because these are from one haul. It's the 506 and the 507 and the E36. These two I use every single day to pack on color, blend out color, to place it precisely. I freaking love these brushes. This is the E36 and this is amazing for detail work. You know, it's fantastic. A lower lash line smoking out, fabulous. This one, I had one of these for a longer time and I actually rediscovered this. This is a new one though because I bought another one. This is the M514 from Morphe and this is a real hair brush, but it is fluffy but smaller. You know, and this is fantastic. This is the brush I use to, well, use as a blending brush, basically, because it is smaller, but still a bit fluffy. If I want a little bit more targeted blending, I grab this one a lot. I do have to say, I do need to learn to work with this a little bit more because I need to work differently with this one than I do with this one. This one I can just, you know, kind of go like that over my eye. This one I need to be a little bit more careful with. But it is an amazing brush. This is the M562. And I actually got this because Paulina from Paulina Beauty is raving about this tiny blending brush. So yeah, I really, really love it. Okay, those were my brushes. Yes. Let's go to eyeshadow palettes. And let's start with this one, which is the Paulina. And this is what she looks like. I did a review. I think I did a first impression, a review, and three looks. And this is the inside. And it is one of my favorites. The trouble is, though, it is no longer available. So I am currently working on duping the shades. Just so that you can kind of follow along with some of the tutorials I've done with this. But yeah, this purple is so freaking pretty. It is just amazing. And now that I look at it, I think I can dupe a lot of the shades. So I need to start swatching and hopefully film the video. But this purple is one of the best purples that I have in my collection. It is so freaking pretty. So let me swatch it. So good. And then the combination between the purple, which is called Salma, and then this hot neony green, which is called Friends. I live for this combination. Oh, this is so gorgeous. It's just insane. The quality is really, really good. The looks that I created with it are very, very pretty. You can really, really play with this palette, and the quality is fantastic. So I freaking love the palette. Again, the downside is it's no longer available. Hence the reason I am, well, trying to dupe some shades for you. Let's go to the second palette. And this one is pretty new. And yeah, my review on it just went up. It's the Flower Child palette by Max Up the Makeup. This is what she looks like. And yeah, in my mind, it's just, you know, a love child between the Zulu and the Douce. And the quality is fantastic. So if you are, you know, you don't know which one to get, the Zulu or the Douce, first off, you can obviously get both. But if you cannot, you only have money for one palette, get this one. It's fantastic. I will link, leave the video or the review and the looks down below, and the first impression as well. These shades are so freaking amazing. It's just insane. These two, which are notoriously difficult to create, top notch. Definitely a fantastic palette. And I cannot wait to dig into that some more. Now we have one eyeshadow palette left. The last eyeshadow palette, which is a favorite, is the Jeffree Star Alien palette. And I'm currently filming the looks. I'm trying to film fit five looks in one video. Yeah, this is look number three. This is what it looks like, in case you don't know. What I love about this palette is the fact that the way he laid it out, it is just amazing, because you can go row by row like this. These three shades work so nicely with each other, as do these three, as do these three. You can go in quads. These two, this one, Space Cowboy, looks brown but has a purple undertone. This one, Probe, looks like a green brown but has a bluish undertone. So these two and these two work so nicely together. Same with these two. I did a look with these two, very, very pretty. And then with Interstellar or Pluto, I don't remember. The way he made these shades are just amazing. The undertones, you can really grunge it up. You can do light looks, you can do dark looks. It's just a fantastic palette. The negative thing about it, though, is because he laid it out like this, there are so many combinations that you can do with this palette, that every time I open the palette, you know, when I film the look, I try to have a plan. I try to. Then I have a plan in my head, I open up the palette, and I'm like, ah, oh, I want to do that one as well. So, you know, I have written down the shades that I used in all three looks. And I need to plan the looks that I film with, because I can do so much with this, you know? And that's just that's a little bit of a thingy as well. But yeah, it's a freaking amazing palette, and I am very glad that I have this palette. So it is a favorite. So, let's go to mascara. And normally I don't have a favorite mascara because a mascara for me only needs to kind of coat my lashes. But I kind of actually do have a favorite mascara. And it's this one. It's the Catrice Glam and Doll Waterproof Mascara. And the wand looks like this. I have compared this on numerous occasions to the Bad Girl Bang from Benefit and said that in my humble opinion they were, well, basically the same. I did film a side by side, but I don't think that I can keep it in that video. What I can do, however, is cut it out and then plop it on my Instagram. I will do that so you can see, hopefully. I need to see the footage first, and otherwise I will film a side-by-side comparison of this one with the Benefit Bad Girl Bang. So yeah, just so you know. So I am going to film that, yes. So that was the mascara, but it is waterproof, which I like. And I can even coat my bottom lashes with it without them looking like spider legs. So I'm very, very happy with that. Falsies. I almost forgot falsies as well. So yeah, the falsies I want to wear every single freaking day are the Sosu Deluxe Lashes in Style Kylie. It's in the silver box. They are from Primark. So this is actually from my birthday haul. I have them on today and they are so very pretty. They're so comfortable. I freaking love those lashes. I like Sosu lashes anyway, but these are my favorite Sosu lashes to date. So yeah, my other favorite lashes, if I want to go a little bit more natural, are these from Girls With Attitude in the style Swept Away. Also from Primark. They are like the Ardell Demi Wispies, only they are a little bit fuller. And I think they are a tad longer, but not a lot. Yeah, those are my favorite lashes. Yes, where is it? Oh yeah, the lippy that I have on now is this one from NYX. It is their Intense, one of the Intense Butter Glosses, but this one is in Cookie Butter. I love this shade so, so, so much. I love it. I have a bunch. You will see the rest of the colors in my whole update video. Wow. I will also link the whole video that I did below as well. But this is my favorite. I have it on now. I keep reaching for this. It just... I'm apparently into kind of light nude, light lips. I don't know, but it is amazing. The formula is really good as well. Now, if you cannot get NYX, for one reason or another, the Essence Vinylicious line, the one in the tubes, you know, these one, but then the glossy tubes, it's pretty much the same formula as the NYX Butter Glosses, just so you know. The last thing that I have in my favorites videos are three lippies as well. There are three of the Generation Mattes from Catrice. It's their new comfortable liquid lipstick formula. I did a swatch video with all 10. I will link it, I hope. But these three shades are my favorites of the 10. I will swatch them real quick. Let's start with the first one, which is 010. This is a little bit of a pinky nude. It's really, really light. I really, really like it. So yeah, the next one is 040. And this is, what is it? I think it is a neutral mid-tone brown bordering on cool. Something like that. It's really, really pretty and goes with a lot of looks. And the last one is a llama pool. And this is such a pretty cool, I don't know what it is, purpley brown mauve. I don't know how you call it, but this is so gorgeous. So those are my three, well, favorite lippies from Catrice. And that is basically the end of the video. So I don't think it is too long. What I want to do, this is going to be a combination video between the whole video and the update. So I did a whole video last month for my January haul. I tried a bunch of, well, I tried all the stuff from my January haul. I also obviously tried some stuff from February. The stuff I love or the stuff I really do not like, goes into my favorites videos with, you know, sometimes some honorary mentions, like for instance the Flower Beauty Blush. So I'm combining this video to include the stuff I love or I hate, well, loathe from my hauls, as are the products that I keep reaching for in that month. And combined with this, and that's the next video that I'm going to film, is my haul plus update video. That's going to be like my style tone unboxings. I'm going to mention, I think I'm going to mention the monthly haul, so in this case the February haul, in the beginning really quickly. So I will just show you the products, and then after that I will give you an update on my January haul. That's basically how I'm going to do it. So if you are just interested in the February haul, you can watch the beginning. If you're interested in both, you know, I will probably leave timestamps below and all that goodness. So that is the combination of the videos. So yeah, I'm going to, well, stop talking and kind of sign off on this video so I can film the next video, because I'm busy today. So yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know down below if you have any of the products. Maybe some tips and tricks, especially for the Kiko Milano Foundation. And yeah, let me know some of your favorites of this month. That's basically it. Remember, I'm still in the middle of filming the looks with the Alien palette. If you have a specific color combination that you would like me to do, leave it down in the comment section below. And I'll see if I can squeeze that into that video for you, because I'm not done filming the looks just yet. So yeah, that was it. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I hope to see you in my next one, which will be very, very soon. So keep your eyes on my channel. Good things are coming, I think. I don't know, you know. I'm just going to... Yeah.